Muthu, come here. I heard you refused to give your bag and slate to your sister.
But, Appa, it's mine. I need it.
You don't need it anymore, Kanna, because you're finished with your school.
But, Appa, school reopens on Monday. My friends Selvam, Shakti, Mani will go to school. I will also go with them.
Look, they're all boys. You're a girl and you're finished with your school.
Why? Boys can only go to school? Girls can't go? It's not fair.
Now stop asking questions and just listen to me. Give your slate to your sister.
I can't.
Don't you dare talk to your father like this, Muthu.
If they take only boys to school, I'll also dress up as a boy and go.
Muthu, why are you crying?
Appa says I should not go to school anymore. He wants me to give my slate to my sister.
Don't worry, I will talk to him.
Very stubborn. Ridiculous.
Welcome, sir. Welcome.
Welcome, sir. Please sit down.
Why is Muthu crying?
Your student is very adamant, sir. She doesn't seem to understand that, as per our tradition, girls are not allowed to continue education after 5th class.
Amma, Muthu is a brilliant student, not only in her class, but also in the entire school. Sir, I plead with you. Please don't stop her education. If you think money is the criteria for not sending her to school, if you don't mind, I could even pay for her education.
That's very kind of you, sir, but that's not the reason.
It's deviating from our tradition. The society will not accept this, sir. I'm sorry.
Although the selfless offer of an exceedingly good human being opened the gates of knowledge to Muthulakshmi, the prevailing societal practice for girls to stop education after Standard 5 proved strong. Muthu was not allowed to continue her schooling. As a concession, she was made to get educated from home and went on to pass her matric exam as a private candidate.
Hey, Muthu has got admission in Maharaja College. I have to go tell her parents.
What? Muthu is going to attend college with the boys? Oh God!
Achacho, she will sit and study with boys.
Won't she be the only girl in class? In fact, the entire college. This is ridiculous. How could they let this happen? I'm going to complain to the panchayat.
Akka, Muthu has got admission in a big college. The Maharaja has given her special permission. She will sit behind a screen and attend classes. It seems the boys will wait for her to come out and only then come out. Kamalamaka, Muthu has come first in the whole university.
From this prevailing scenario, in which a majority of women found themselves in most parts of India in the late 19th century, emerged a few like Muthulakshmi, who in some way or the other boldly expressed their wish to be treated on par with men. Apart from man-made challenges, there were those existential challenges that loomed gigantically over the people, casting a dark shadow of remorse. A few months after Muthulakshmi lost her sister to cancer, as a medical apprentice, she was witness to an incident.
You've done exceedingly well, my dear. After 5 years of a follow-up, I'm delighted to say we're going to close your case as cured.
That's so wonderful, Doctor. I can't believe this news. Thank you so much, Doctor.
Doctor, do you mean that she's been completely cured of her rectal cancer?
Yes.
May I ask how?
Interested, aren't you? Meet me tomorrow during break and I'll explain how.
That spirit of confidence that Muthu had seen in the eyes of Sir Ernest and his patient in the ability to cure cancer ignited a spark of longing in Muthulakshmi to instill that confidence in the minds of doctors and patients alike in India. Back home, she moved a resolution at the Madras Medical College for the establishment of a self-contained cancer hospital. A few years later, WIA launched the Cancer Relief Fund under the dynamic leadership of Sarojini Varadappan, who went on to become the president of WIA and years later received Padma Bhushan, the third highest civilian award in the country for her social service. With additional aid from the Ministry of Health and the Government of India, the foundation for the first block of Cancer Institute was laid in 1955. 6 decades later, the Cancer Institute has grown to be one of the best equipped hospitals for the treatment of cancer in the whole of Asia.